It's 5 o'clock in the morning.
I was born to rule the Seven Kingdoms.
I'm Euron Greyjoy. I claim the throne.
I wasn't born to be king. I paid the iron price.
I am Yara Greyjoy. I claim the throne.
I want to be the queen.
We've never had a queen.
I now proclaim Cersei of the House Lannister, first of her name, Queen Protector of the Seven Kingdoms. Long may she reign.
You stand in the presence of Daenerys Stormborn of House Targaryen, rightful heir to the Iron Throne. Rightful Queen of the Andals and the First Men, Protector of the Seven Kingdoms, the Mother of Dragons, the Khaleesi of the Great Grass Sea, the Unburnt, the Breaker of Chains.
This is Jon Snow. He's King in the North.
To the King in the North! To the King in the North! To the King in the North! To the King in the North!
What's up, Game of Throners and fellow YouTubers? It's your boy DJ11 here, back at you with another one. And what's up? We got another one. The latest in Ommegang, their next release. Game of Thrones for the Throne. I can't even believe it. I actually picked this up almost 3 weeks ago, like literally a couple days after it was in the store, and I cannot believe I have not tapped into it yet. Didn't even drink it for like the opening. I mean, I guess it's not that unbelievable. I mean, I did have one or two options to pick from, and we made it a whiskey night. But yeah, we had to go with the Oban Bay Reserve, the Night's Watch. But yeah, I have definitely been dying to try this. As you know, I have pretty much tried every single Game of Thrones beer they have, except for two of them. I haven't tried the Bend the Knee or the Three-Eyed Raven, I believe it was, the second one they ever came out with. So yeah, I've been trying them all, loved most of them, except for that Royal Reserve collection was just not good. If you haven't tried it and you've been seeing it still in your store, there's a reason it's still staying around. Every single one of these like sells out almost instantly in that collection. You can still buy. There's a reason for it. Save your money. Unless you can get the barley wine, the Hand of the Queen, the silver one, which you can. That's the one out of the collection you can never see anymore. And it was the first one they came out with. But that was actually my favorite one out of every Game of Thrones beer made. Like, a lot of people didn't really like that one. I'm not really a beer guy, so maybe the fact that it was barley wine, I don't know, but I really enjoyed that one. So let's see how the For the Thrones is going to compare to that one. All right, see if we can open this without making a crazy mess. You already know it's probably just going to blow everywhere. Boom! You like that noise? Oh, clean. Oh, dang. That smells good. I believe this is a golden ale. Have to look into that and read it up real quick, but yeah, nice and icy cold. Been sitting in the fridge for a while, so let's get it in.
And everybody started singing.
I was doing so good. Now here comes the foam. Bada boom, bada boom. You know, you already know we gotta be drinking it in the legitimate Game of Thrones Ommegang beer glass, so you're gonna nerd out, get your nerd completely out. Oh, definitely excited to taste this one. We're gonna let this foam go down and see what it's like. Smells like kind of pears and apricots. And not super malty, kind of more of like a crisp and clean ale. The more of that amber, just real crisp and clean smell, like, yeah, apricots and pears. More of a, I don't know, more of a, I don't want to say light beer, but yeah, it just doesn't have that real thick malty smell. Yeah, head's starting to go down, maybe better pour a little more in there. Oh yeah, oh yeah. That's going to be so good. Yeah, I'm excited to taste this. And while we're waiting for the foam to go down.
Complex and compelling, yet delicate and refined, For the Throne is our tribute to the final occupant of the Iron Throne. For the Throne begins with a Belgian-style ale base, which is co-fermented with a blend of Pinot Grigio and Vino Noir grapes. After bottling, this luxurious libation undergoes a secondary fermentation with champagne yeast to achieve a sparkling effervescence and a crisp, clean finish. Truly an ale fit for royalty. Winter is here, the wall has fallen, and the final battle for Westeros is underway. With this offering, we have bent the traditional boundaries of beer making, co-fermentation traditional ingredients with juices normally destined for fine wines, going to great lengths to create a truly unique, special beer. The Ommegang Brewery president, Doug Campbell, says this style of beer, often called Owen beer, is a rapidly expanding area of study for them. For the Throne is their first co-fermentation beer of 2019, and the only one they've launched under the Game of Thrones banner.
All right, I think I've read enough about it. I am definitely ready to taste it. It smells so good. It's got like a really crisp, fresh smell. Like I said, it's jumping out. Jumping out of the glass. I mean, I'm not a super big beer guy, but I'm excited to taste this one. I know it's got to be better than, Yeah, I don't know why, but even before I smelled this one and opened it up, I just had a good feeling about this one. It kind of reminds me of another one, the Iron Throne, which, how shocking. For the Throne and the Iron Throne taste pretty similar, but this one's actually even better. And the shocking thing is, the one thing I have to say about that last collection is two of the strongest ones was the actual King of the North was the strongest one at 11%, and then my favorite one, the Hand of the Queen, was the second strongest one out of the entire collection, and that's like 10.7% alcohol. This one is pretty impressive at 9.5% alcohol, so not too shabby. And the next one, the fourth one, was Valo de Haras. That was another one of my favorite ones, and that one's actually 9% alcohol. So all the other ones, they vary. You have anything from 8, 6.7, 7. I mean, they're all over the place. But those are the four strongest ones, and this is right up there as the third strongest one in the collection. And for being the third strongest one and this tasty, bravo. Because, I mean, it's not just all right. It's actually really good. Like, I'm looking forward to this and probably will end up going and buying another one. Damn you, Game of Thrones Ommegang. But it's nice to actually, I like when they actually have a decent taste in one, and this is it. Chill this one, ice cold, sit back, and watch a nice episode of Game of Thrones. You can't go wrong. Yeah, the Iron Throne, Tyrion sitting right in front of it there on his little Iron Throne, because I guess they're just trying to tell us that he's going to be sitting at the Iron Throne at the end of it, but I don't know about that. But yeah, this one tastes a lot like that one, a lot like that original Iron Throne. It's a golden ale, so I mean, it's going to be, but they've had some pretty crazy flavors, and they have definitely had some hit or misses throughout the collections, but this one is definitely a thumbs up. I mean, this is 8.5 out of 10. Game of Thrones, For the Throne, absolutely, yeah. Whoever sits on the Iron Throne would definitely, especially back in Westeros, would be very happy to drink this one. And like I said, man, it has been very hit or miss with all these beers, so it is nice to get one that I enjoy. I would absolutely go back and buy another bottle of this. What did I pay for it? I honestly don't remember. Like I said, it's been like 3 weeks since I freaking bought this thing. I'm going to guess I paid somewhere between $11.99 and maybe $14.99, somewhere in there. I'm going to say, yeah, somewhere between $11 and $15. I don't know. But yeah, I collect them, so it's worth it for me to get it. And there are very few that I've tasted that I would buy another one. The Hand of the Queen, the barley wine is one. And this is... there are very few. I mean, other than the barley wine, I'm trying to think. The Iron Throne was good. I believe the winner and the Valo Morghulis, or the Valo de Haras. Which is the blue one? The Valo de Haras and the Winner is Here. Those were both pretty good. So yeah, this is about maybe the fourth one I would actually buy a second one of. So yeah. Tasty, and I am a big fan, just like I am of the show, because with the first episode, it was pretty much exactly what you thought it would be, a nice little setup, and they're about to start bringing it. Oh, Jaime Lannister on trial. What's going to happen? I guess we'll find out tomorrow. So, yeah, anybody who was thinking about buying the Game of Thrones For the Throne bottle, I highly, highly thumbs up and suggest it and back this one. Like I said, I would save your money on that last collection, but this one's back on track, 100%, For the Throne. Cheers, everybody.
blame it on my alcohol, blame it on my